If you're navigating the loss of a loved one, this video goes over a writing exercise to help you move towards healing. In this video, I'll offer an unconventional tool to help you cope with grief. Hi there, I'm Dr. Marie Fang. Welcome to my video series featuring quick tips and tools to help you be your best self today. Today we're going to go over an unconventional yet very powerful tool we utilize in grief work, writing a letter from your loved one addressed to you. Yes, you heard me correctly. I know an often utilized tool is to write a letter from ourselves addressed to our loved ones, and that is also an incredibly helpful exercise. However, today we're going to flip the script. Often what we're wanting from our loved ones is to hear from them. What do they think about how we're carrying out our lives right now? Are they proud of us? What would they say if they could see you right now? This is what flipping the script allows us to do when we write a letter from our loved one addressed to us. Though there's no one correct way to write such a letter, I'm going to offer a few prompts here to help you get started. First, find a photo of your loved one or of the two of you. Take a look at the photo and take some time to reflect on their character and aspects of them that you cherish. If you have access, find gifts that they've given to you or items of theirs that you have to also remind you of them. Next, on a piece of paper or in a journal, begin writing a letter as though you are your loved one addressing yourself in the second person. This might feel a little bit strange at first, but you're likely to get into a flow soon enough. Allow yourself to take some creative liberties as you imagine what your loved one might say if they wrote a letter to you. It's also an option to simply write out what you wish your loved one might say to you. The goal here is not to be as accurate as possible, but to allow your spirit to engage in the activity. Once you've finished writing your letter, feel free to hang on to it and reread it from your own perspective. You may find it helpful to find a safe place to keep it, to pull it out from time to time when you're missing your loved one or when you're having a tough go in life. Keep in mind that there are no official rules for this process, so feel free to make it yours and have fun. You might write letters back and forth to your loved one. You might write sticky notes from your loved one and put them around your house. Or maybe you'd like to make a decorative piece of artwork that reflects a nickname they would have for you or a favorite inside joke you'd have together so that you feel surrounded by words from your loved one. These reminders of love and care from your loved one can be incredibly powerful in your healing journey. Well, I hope you found this tip helpful. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe for more videos like this one. And until next time, I'm Dr. Marie Fang, and I hope you have a great day.